Good morning, good afternoon, or good night, whatever time it may be in your part of the world. My name is Mr. John Wayne, and I am a variety gamer. I play everything from the Fallout franchise all the way to the Soulsborne series. Welcome, everybody, to another episode of my 100% walkthrough of Fallout 4. I hope you're all doing well. I know that I am. And today, we're going to be making our way to the Nucleus and finishing up a few side quests for Far Harbor. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. First thing we're going to do is come over here, backtrack just a little bit, pull out our gun because the wasteland is dangerous. We're going to hang a right down this road, head west.
Hey, you mind keeping an eye out for a sec? I gotta run a diagnostic. Whew. Thanks. What'd they miss?
Couldn't take long.
You did good.
See what he dropped us. Nice. That's actually not a bad revolver. Slows time for just a moment. Just keep following this road down. We're gonna kill a couple of trappers real quick.
Something out there. Coast clear.
I want to see what he dropped. I mean, it's not bad, but I'm just not wearing leather armor. Let's go back out to the road. Follow it on down. Gonna go over here to the edge of the broken bridge. We're gonna fight our first hermit crab.
Your funeral. That's the last. Someone called for exterminators.
Jeez. Did not notice them. Where do you have some heavy combat armor? We don't need any of that. We're going to turn around. There's a fork in the road here. We came from the left. We're going to head to the right. Go straight down. We're going to be picking up the tools for the mariner right over here at the tannery. We're going to have a ton of ghouls over here, but nothing we can't handle. Ghouls are fairly easy compared to other stuff in Far Harbor. Actually, ghouls are pretty easy compared to anything in the wasteland. There's a ghoul right here.
Cannibals.
I feel like I reload too much. I'm always reloading. There's a single trapper down there. I don't know what he's doing.
Now.
out the ghoul right there. There's another one right over here.
Sorry, folks, won't be chewing on us.
We want to clear this place out ahead of time. That way we don't have to worry about it later. Grab that cap stash. And if you want to lockpick that chest, you can. We're going to come back around and go through this blue door. I'll see everybody inside. Let's go ahead and lockpick this door.
Yes.
Going to take out both the ghouls right here. Man, I have been getting really lucky with legendaries lately. I don't know what I did to deserve this, but I'll take it.
Cannibal, anyone you walk away from.
We're gonna go downstairs, kill a couple more ghouls. And then we'll be done.
Don't be a last stand. You're playing long since. Just when I thought we were getting along.
We're gonna pick up the tannery key from him. And then we're gonna come over here and pick up the power tools. And then loot this steamer trunk for anything we might want. And then we're gonna go outside.
Hey.
Hold up! I've been casing those ghouls for weeks, waiting for an opening. And you dive in, and choppy chop, bang bang, and the whole lot of them, dead. You even know what you got right there? A premium set of Pelman's power tools.
I remember commercials for Pelman's tools. Expensive stuff, the top of the line.
What the hell's a commercial? Wait, it don't matter. Oh, Mariner sent you, didn't she? Goddamn Mitch and his big mouth. No matter what she's offering, it's nothing. Serious builders would give an arm for them tools. I'll pay you 2,000 caps right here, right now. Deal?
That is a good deal, but no thank you.
I'll pass on the offer.
I ain't hanging around forever. Walk away from this, and you'll regret it.
No, I think you'll regret it more than me. We're gonna exit the tannery and continue on our journey. Now we're gonna make our way towards the nucleus. Take a right down this path. We're not going to do anything but discover the nucleus today. I think in the next video is when we're going to start doing stuff for the nucleus, like side quests and gaining entry into it, all that good stuff. For now, we're going to be finishing up a bunch of content for Far Harbor and for Acadia. This chest is so hard to loot for some reason. Over here's a really cool cinema. This is Eden Meadows Cinema. You should definitely check it out if you can. Well, not if you can, but if you'd like to. I'm not going to. It's nothing special, it's just a really cool point of interest. Over here you can see some ghouls that are entranced by the screen. Let's keep making our way down this path. Keep making our way down this road. Right here's a fork in the road. You want to take the left path. If you got a good eye, sometimes you'll see gulpers chilling out in the trees. It's usually where they're at. See right there? There's a gulper. You can shoot it down. And kill it before it even sees you.
Something out there. Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
Come over here and loot this gulper as well. We're gonna get back on the road. Followed on down. There's an antenna array station up top there. It's not really that interesting. There's a Nuka-Cola Quantum up there if you want to get it. I'm not gonna bother discovering it. But if you want to, feel free to climb this mountain. Bunch of super mutants over there. So be careful. We're gonna be veering off to the left here so we don't have to deal with them. I know it's kind of hard to see the path because of the sun in our eyes and the radiation storm going on, but follow the path through here as best as possible. Come down here and just hug the water's edge. This will lead us straight to the nucleus. We'll be taking that path here shortly. Careful, there's usually an angler over here and sometimes a fog crawler. We'll see if we have the angler and the fog crawler. Hopefully just the angler. And then there should be... Yep, there's the fog crawler. Can't really see through the fog. Okay, it's gone. We don't have to worry about it. Oh well. I was gonna kill it, but it ran off. I scared it. Maybe. I don't know. Nick, go kill it. Okay, right over here is the nucleus.
Richter, please, you can't do this. We've
been loyal. It's Grand Zealot to you, and your dedication has come into doubt. You need to prove your faith. One of you may return to the fold. The other will return to Adam.
Richter, this is insane. You can't expect us to...
Will there be anything else?
That'll be all, sister.
Thank you, Grand Zealot.
Brutal.
You. What are you doing here? Did Far Harbor send you?
I was sent here by a child of Adam I met outside of Acadia.
That's so. Likely more of Sister Harriet's good work. So, you've come to find a place among Adam's children, then?
What was happening with those two children of Adam you were, interrogating?
An issue of loyalty. Not something you need to concern yourself with. Now, unless you've come to join Adam's faithful, I suggest you go on your way.
I'm interested in joining. Sign me up.
Decisions of who may enter our family, we leave to Adam. You'll have to perform a ritual. Prove yourself worthy in his eyes.
All right. I'll do what Adam requires.
Then let us hope he deems you fit. There is a small spring not far from here. Drink from it. Follow where it leads. You come back, we'll discuss you joining the faithful.
We'll end up doing that in the next video. For now, let's continue on our path. We gotta get the storage devices for Dima, or technically for Faraday, but it's Dima's storage devices. Oh, there's that fog crawler again. You ready to die? Yep, it's ready to die. We're gonna follow the water's edge again.
Who do you think actually won the war?
And then right here is where we're gonna cross over. Head southeast. Right over here are the storage drives. And then we'll interact with Victoria's trunk.
Only opens with a key.
Over here's a steamer trunk. We're gonna go up these stairs. There's gonna be a couple of, well, actually more than a couple. There's gonna be quite a few trappers over here. We're gonna take them out as quick as we can. I think the trapper bugged out. Let's turn off this jukebox. Kill that fool. Another guy up here. Take him out real quick. Hey. Wasn't sure if I could actually loot him from there. Another trapper in here. You can kill them if you want. I'm just gonna let them be. Gonna head through here, going north. We're gonna follow this road. Gonna make a right down this road. Follow it south. And this is gonna lead us straight back to Far Harbor so we can turn in some side quests. There's usually some wolves over here. Just be careful.
I won't be bothering anybody now.
We're going to be coming up to the Harbor Grand Motel. Be really careful. There are a ton of super mutants. If you want to run right past it, I don't blame you. I'm not going to be fighting the super mutants. We can come back to the Harbor Grand Motel later on. We'll see if that's something that we do. I haven't got that far into planning. Seriously, though, with all the legendaries, man. I don't know why they're giving me so many, but it's an insane amount. Let's just keep running northeast down this road. Run away from the super mutants. You're a stupid green man. We're gonna run into some more trappers here. Finish them off. Hurt myself. And then just keep heading north to northeast. We did get a level. Let's go ahead and put a level in real quick. We're going to put it into endurance. And then the next level that we're going to put in is going to be medic. And then we'll focus on endurance and then luck. We'll get the special stats maxed out first and then we'll worry about everything else. Be careful, a lot of times there's some trappers over there. Again, I'm not bothered with that stuff. A lot of enemies for us are lower levels. So sometimes I feel like it's not worth killing them. Should be some wolves over here. Pick up a little bit of wolf meat, why not? Use it for some taxidermy stuff. Be careful of the mire lurks. All that hard work fixing the fog condensers and then they're not even here anymore. Keep following this road down. We're almost to Far Harbor. Everything should look a little familiar. Let's go talk to the mariner. Oh, they killed the child of Adam.
Anything useful?
Before we got here. That sucks. There's usually a little cutscene. Well, not really a cutscene, but a scene of Alan Lee and Avery interrogating a child of Adam and then shoots them.
Guns, and more guns.
Mariner.
You been to the tannery? You find my tools yet?
Here are your tools.
A fair bit of luck running into you. Here's your reward. Well earned. And now to work on the hull.
Let's go over to Cassie here in a second. First, we're going to talk to Teddy Wright.
Hey.
You are a curious specimen. Despite our friendly town doing its best to chase you out, you keep helping us ingrates all the same. I got to ask, why do you keep at it?
You're good people in some dire straits. Figured you could use a hand.
Huh? You running for office? Well, if that's the truth, we don't deserve you. Most folk here are set in their ways, yes? It makes no difference how hard you try to get in good with them. Heck, it took my family 3 generations before the Daltons would sell us a heel of bread. But there's a way. A downright insane way, mind you. You can turn even the most stubborn fool around.
I'd love to change their opinion of me.
Do it right, and all mainlanders might get treated better. In olden times, leaders were chosen by something called the Captain's Dance. Legends say the toughest, meanest, and outright craziest hopefuls would chum the waters and lure out the worst the island could throw at them. Once the would-be captain killed the Mirelur Queen, or fog crawler, or what have you, they'd invite the whole island to feast off the bounty. You do this? Well, you won't be made captain, but you'll earn respect. Everyone's respect.
I'm ready to become a legend, then.
You what? You crack me up. There's an old Mirelur feasting grounds by Emmett's Causeway, a treacherous stretch along the coast. Go there and throw any kind of meat you got into the water. All that blood and viscera will be sure to attract attention. And then wait. I'll make sure there's a witness or two. Prove to the rest of these clods you belong.
Let's talk to Teddy one more time.
Hey, Doc.
You here for doctoring?
Who's Andre?
Poor Andre is my patient over there. He spent too long a spell in the fog. You may think you know your mainland radiation poisoning, but we got our own special brand here.
I know a few things about medicine. Can I try to help him?
You say, what? You? Help? Well, poor Andre's got it bad. Good as dead. Well, I suppose there's no harm letting you have a poke, but I'll be watching you.
Let's take a look.
So as long as your intelligence is 8 or higher, or you have medic plus 2, then you can heal Andre. If not, I wouldn't even bother.
Well, I'll be. I think you may have done it. I'll keep looking after Andre. But I think thanks to you, he's got a fighting chance.
Let's go talk to Cassie.
Grandpa George can rest in peace. The fog crawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger I hoped you were. With that fog crawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Really, it's no trouble.
Well, I hope you know how much it means to me that Grandpa George can finally rest in peace. Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong as any a person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
Believe me, I know exactly how you feel.
If that's true, then I'm sorry to hear it. Perhaps we'll confront our pain together. My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mole rats. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
I'll make that trapper pay.
All right, then. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.
Let's go ahead and go into our Pip-Boy, and we're going to go fast travel over to Acadia. Let's go turn in some of these side quests for Acadia.
Your missing synth was jumped by cannibal trappers. He didn't survive.
That poor bastard. That synth came here to live in peace, and we failed him in the worst way possible. It's my fault. I should have gone out there to meet him. Damn it all. I'm glad we were able to bring some closure to the matter. You deserve this. And shall we say 200 caps?
I'm sorry things didn't turn out better. I wish they had.
You and I both. Thanks again for your help. Be safe out there.
It's actually not a bad Institute rifle. You get 10% damage while aiming.
Hey.
Yes?
I've got those storage drives you asked for.
Oh, that's great. Thank you. Just the two? Really? I somehow thought there were three.
I did notice a locked chest that I couldn't open. Maybe the last one was in there. Do you have the key?
Key? Chest? I'm afraid I don't know. You know what? This is fine. Just these two is fine. Well, you did your part, so I'll do mine. Thank you for recovering these.
We're gonna head out of Acadia just for a second and go to Far Harbor. So we're gonna go over to Far Harbor. Let's talk to the Mariner.
Those tools you found are a joy to work with. It gave me this idea. A cargo freighter, founded ages ago, to the south. With a bit of arc welding and some elbow grease, the hull could be reinforced to be sturdy. Fierce. Best to do it soon. Before... well, soon.
One cargo freighter coming up.
The island should never be underestimated. The ship's the MS Azalea. Expect trappers. Mean ones. Once you mop the decks with them, I'll send my crew over. Best of luck.
We're going to head over to the MS Azalea.
Let the island catch you off guard. By my gun.
Also, now there's some palisades or wood spikes. That's from us getting the tools for the Mariner. We're going to head south out at Far Harbor.
A lot of rads around. We should get out of here.
We're gonna go get some revenge for Chase while we're heading to the MS Azalea. We're gonna kill these cannibal trappers that killed that synth.
Someone's coming. Don't underestimate us again.
Now let's continue down this road. Veer off to the left just a little bit. It's really easy to go down there instead of following the road. So just be mindful of that. We're gonna take the path to the right. We're almost to the MS Azalea. It's just up this path here. You can also find these buckets on trees scattered all through Far Harbor. It'll give you some sap. There's another one right here. Let's go ahead and kill ourselves some trappers. Ooh, everything is bugged out. That's really weird. It's all right. We'll get through this. If this happens to you, what I would do is a quick save and then just reload the game. The hard part is finding the entry points, because you can see them through here, but on the other side you can't. Really weird bug.
Yes! Fight for
you were smarter than this. That's the last.
Couple more to kill.
We playing hide and seek? Coast looks clear.
Here it looks like we can't go through here. I promise you we can.
Got guts. Well, had guns.
You're dead already!
I'm trying to figure out which way to go. There we go. Right here. Where's that trapper at?
Run! Run while you can!
Oh, is he in the water?
Alright.
Okay, he's dead. Doesn't matter. Let's go ahead and fast travel back over to Far Harbor.
Don't underestimate those trappers by the Azalea.
The MS Azalea is good to go.
I'll send the work crew over. And once we haul a piece of the ship here, the hull will be a sight to see.
Now we're going to go back over to Acadia. We're gonna go downstairs here. A lot of back and forth today. We're gonna lockpick this storage room.
Nice.
Let's loot a little bit real quick. I don't know how they don't see me with my Pip-Boy light on and me crouching in front of a big window. Makes no sense.
We need to accomplish this without bloodshed. Far Harbor and the Children of Adam have a right to exist on this island, the same as us.
They're going to kill each other, Dima. There's no stopping it. We need to pick a side now.
Haven't we already picked a side? Building the fog condensers around Far Harbor wasn't exactly a neutral act.
We couldn't stand by and let the people of this island die to the fog.
Just like you couldn't just leave the Cult of Adam without a home? Giving them the submarine base was a mistake. The nucleus, as they're calling it, is basically one big fortified position.
Far Harbor had cast them out. They have strange beliefs, but they have always accepted us for what we are. And Confessor Martin was a friend.
Well, the new Confessor isn't. High Confessor Tectus is an unstable megalomaniac, and he's gonna keep threatening us as long as we're helping Far Harbor.
Guys, can we talk about the elephant in the room? We keep dancing around it.
My old memory banks in the submarine base.
I can't believe you never told me about those. I have to wait until they become a security risk.
I know how it looks in hindsight, but at the time, it was an act of trust. I was honestly more worried they'd accidentally trip the pre-war security and get hurt. Giving the children my old home, allowing them to safeguard my old memories, I thought our people would be working together.
Just how secure are the banks? How long do we have? And what's in them?
I've gone over this before, Chase. I don't know what's in them. That's how it works. It's as close to forgetting something as I have. But I've run some projections of worst-case scenarios. If we do nothing and the wrong knowledge falls in the wrong hands...
So send me over there. I'll be in and out in a day.
We can't risk it. They know you're from Acadia. If you're caught, or even seen, then it's war.
We should at least prepare her to go in. We're running out of options. I say we tell her how to crack into the memory banks.
You've been working on this without me?
It came up in a private moment, Chase. But yes, we've been writing a program that will let you access and download my memories. It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'm finishing up some tweaks to the program right now. I'll leave a copy of it for you on my desk when I'm done.
Get the program, use it to break into the memory banks. Got it.
Hopefully you won't have to. We'll keep monitoring the situation. I only want you going in if we have no other choice.
He's got his fingers everywhere on this island. And whatever's in his memories isn't something we can wait for someone else to find.
We're gonna go grab that tape up top from Faraday's desk. Go talk to Kasumi.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're going to find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind? Is there really something in them that's dangerous? Do you have a way in? Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the children of Adam, of course.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does? Some kind of connection between your head and the computer. I'll bet that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it? You'll let me know what you find? I'll keep an eye on things here.
I'll get Dima's memories, and then we'll figure things out from there.
Good luck.
Too many folks these days count on violence to solve their problems. We only have to look around to see where that got us.
Let's go upstairs. We're gonna talk to Dima. Before we talk to Dima, let's go ahead and put a level in. We're gonna put it into Medic. Let's talk to Dima.
Dima,
did you need something?
I know you left some of your memories behind in an old submarine base, that you're worried the children of Adam will get to them.
You've been busy. I was hoping you were taking your time learning more about us. I suppose you have. Maybe this is an opportunity for both of us. I can't send any of my people without risking the children of Adam linking them back to Acadia. But you're new to the island.
All right. I'm listening.
Before I begin, how much do you know? Did you have any questions for me? About Far Harbor, the children of Adam, or my memories?
I know all I need to.
Then my plan is simple. Pose as a recruit and infiltrate the children of Adam. Gain access to their base in the old command center, guarded by some pre-war security measures. You'll find my memory banks. I'll give you the program you need in order to access my memories. Bring me anything you find. It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
Actually, I already have the program. I was thorough.
Well, I guess that just means I've picked the right person for the job. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the children of Adam directly. Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
If we find anything suspicious in those memories of yours, we'll be back. Count on it.
It's good to see you again, brother.
I prefer we keep it to just Nick and Dima for now.
Of course.
Let's go outside and head to Far Harbor again. We're gonna talk to Nick real quick.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Hey, Valentine.
What? Oh, sorry. Just got my head full of what Dima was talking about. That's a bit of a shock. What do you think he is, really? Family?
It's hard to deny it, Nick. The similarities are pretty obvious.
I spent a long time wondering if the Institute had made any other prototypes. If I was just a failure, or they gave up, or just plain got bored. I always thought I was just more of their discarded trash. I never thought of the possibility that someone wanted me out. Helped me escape. There's got to be some kind of proof out there. What really happened between me and Dima? I'd appreciate it if we could keep an eye out.
Of course, Nick. We'll find something.
Thanks. I know we don't have much to go on. Just keep me in mind if you find something that might give us some answers.
Maybe some.
All right, now let's go ahead and go over to Far Harbor.
Someday more places in the
Mainlander. I got one last idea. Crazier than a box of rat roaches. That hasn't stopped you before. Hull's got plenty of stopping power now. But if a Mirelurk Queen went for a frontal assault...
I'd like to help if I can.
I had a feeling I could count on you. Thicker walls can beat the whole mass-velocity force issue. But the bigger problem is acid. Only thing I've ever seen survive a Queen's acid are other Mirelurks. The Mirelurks on our islands have carapaces that are extra tough. So you gather up a bunch of the carapaces and lug them back here. Then I'll reinforce the town as best as I'm able.
Far Harbor really owes you for all this.
Yes and no. It's my dock people are squatting on, so I got a personal stake in it. Good luck.
Alrighty, everyone. This is where we're going to end the video. I want to start by telling everybody thank you so very much for stopping by and watching the video. It really does mean the world to me. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down button. Let me know why down in the comments below. It only helps the channel. Also, if you enjoy content just like this, be sure to subscribe or don't. I don't know. I'm not your dad. Do whatever you want. And like always, everybody, have a good morning, a good afternoon, or good night, whatever time it may be in your part of the world. Mr. John Wayne, signing off.